stabilized, and if it has not stabilized, is there any chances that the Himalayas would gain further height?
Okay, now you've asked me a question which is beyond earthquakes. Okay. Now what happens is, in the wedge, there are two things that happen. One is deformation. You remember I showed you those, can I just go back to, you know, those velocity field things? So, you know, so you have uplift. Okay? So you have uplift which deforms and builds topography.
Let's go further south. Down, down, down.
Maybe this one. Okay? So this one is actually telling you there's vertical uplift. Okay, because it has a high vertical velocity. So this is the part that is rising, that is deformed. So here you are going to build the mountain. Okay? But once you create a mountain, immediately once you create a positivity, wind, water, everything starts, you know, kind of eroding it, and it wants to bring it to where it was. So all the mountain runs in the world, there's a constant tussle between the two. So as long as deformation is there, that there are parts where deformation is active, so that part will be dominated by deformation. And once you stop the deformation, you know, erosion will be done. Ultimately, in this race, erosion wins. Because mountain dies, the compression and all that dies, and it's just cutting plain. If you look at Peninsula India, you look at Rajasthan, it's all been almost plain. So Himalaya is going to go that way in a few hundred million years or so. Okay, once this compression. So there's a constant tussle between, you know, eroding factors which reduces the topography and deformation which builds it. So the wedge is never stable. Okay, it's not in equilibrium. Okay? So as long as this is going on, wherever suppose erosion wins somewhere, then the deformation actually fill needs to, you know, basically deform and fill them. Okay? It's only when whole system becomes stable, then it worries about overcoming the friction and going to the fall. So the only time the wedge is momentarily completely stable is when you drive the grader. Okay? And that point the whole thing moves forward. It jerks forward, the whole wedge. Okay? And that's the reason why you get such high bending. So once you have like a, you know, where the fault is breaking in between, right, and you are not getting large earthquakes, you just, okay, can you just scroll down? So when these are happening, see, here's a valley here. Okay? The equilibrium configuration of this wedge should be like this. Correct? This part has been eroded more than the other part. So this deformation needs to build this to get equilibrium. Okay? It's only when everything is kind of stable that this happens. Okay? So it's very momentarily that the wedge actually gets it. So when this is happening, you know, there is something going on here where erosion is winning and it's trying to fill that void. Okay. So this is more advanced, you need not worry about that.
Yeah, so like you keep saying that the Everest is rising and all that. I think we are still moving up or
Everest in the last Nepal earthquake actually came down a little bit. Okay, so when you have an earthquake, wherever you have the epicenter, at that point things shift. Okay.